United Airlines flight. They forced the passenger to put a 10-month-old puppy in the overhead compartment, and when the plane landed in New York, the dog was dead. Daria Albinger from ABC News joins us to talk about the latest. Good morning, Daria.
Good morning, McGraw. I got to tell you, you know, as a journalist, I try to be impartial on these stories, but as a dog owner, this one is tough.
Yeah, no, I think a lot of people have that feeling. So what actually happened?
So here's what happened. It was on a flight from Houston to New York. There was a mother, a daughter, and her infant daughter, and their 10-month-old French bulldog puppy. Now, in all fairness to the airlines, there are very clear guidelines as to how you can travel with a pet. And what it means, in most cases, is that unless it's an emotional support animal, the pet must travel in a carrier that can fit under the front seat. Now, the carrier that this dog was in was too big to do that. So the carrier was in the aisle of the plane. The flight attendant said, it can't stay there. It's got to go in the overhead bin. There was a little bit of a language barrier between the mother and the flight attendant. The mother was predominantly a Spanish speaker, not very proficient in English. Her daughter, however, spoke fluent English and said vehemently, it's a dog. It can't go in the bin. It can't go in the bin. The flight attendant insisted, put the carrier in the bin. The dog barked on takeoff and then went silent. And by the time they landed, the dog was dead.
All right. So can dogs travel with the checked luggage?
They can travel with the checked luggage. And in fact, I've done this with one of my dogs in the past. I'm not sure I'd ever do it again. But if the dog is over 20 pounds, that's generally the guideline. If it's over a toy-sized breed, it can't go under the seat in the carrier. So it's got to travel in the cargo hold. Now, there are some vets, in fact, a majority of vets who will say that's generally not the best way, you know, to travel.
So, Daria, isn't there like for the size of the carrier, too, didn't they notice maybe in check-in that the carrier might have been too big?
That's what a lot of people are questioning, that how come this got to the point that it did? How come it wasn't noticed by the time that they went on, you know, they got on the plane? Now, I can remember when I flew with one of my dogs, when I had her as a puppy, I actually was given by the airline, I bought it, a temporary carrier.
Right.
And it was, you know, it was able to, you know, it was a one-use thing, and I was able to fit it under the seat. So that's the question on a lot of people's minds. How this went through airport security, how it went through the gate check-in, how it went through all of these supposed stopgaps, and it still got onto the plane.
So is the overhead compartment airtight? I find it hard to believe that the dog suffocated up in the overhead compartment.
You know, I don't know that for a fact. I mean, I would imagine that it is watertight because there could be all kinds of problems, you know, otherwise.
Right.
If, you know, and not just from pets, but from people who carry things in their carry-on bags.
Right.
But there is a lot of jostling up there. This was not a full-grown dog. It was a puppy. The puppy may have been jostled, may have had, you know, a traumatic injury that way. There are a lot of things that can happen. So there's a lot of unanswered questions right now on this story. United is apologizing. They are taking full responsibility. And the flight attendant did say afterwards that she didn't realize that it really was a dog.
Right. But what did you want the flight attendant, not you, but what did they want the flight attendant to do if the thing's too big for the aisle and it's too big to put under your seat and you can't put it on your lap? What did you want the flight attendant to do?
That's a really good question. I mean, the flight attendant was doing her job, maybe a little too much to the letter of the law for some people.
Right.
But she was doing her job. The family, you know, obviously was in distress. Now, you know, one of the vets that I spoke to yesterday when I started researching the story said, you know, if it wasn't a full flight, why didn't they just move the family to another row where there might have been a seat between them and then charged them for an extra seat if they had to?
Yeah. Daria Albinger with ABC News. Good stuff. Thanks for checking in.
Thank you.
You got it.